Sunday night, I asked that Minister Matalashi resign, given his conduct both directly in Parliament in terms of misleading and lying to Parliament in respect of matters pertaining to whether there were contacts or not in relation to the development of the country. A lie and misleading is not only occurring by reason of a person making a deliberate statement of mistruth, but it also happens when a person omits to tell the truth when clearly they are in a position to do so. This is a serious matter. I said on Sunday night that on Thursday morning, had we not resigned, we would then be calling on the acting Prime Minister of the country to take action. Today is Thursday, and we are therefore holding faith with what we indicated to the public on Sunday. And let me frame the two issues very clearly and succinctly for you. On Tuesday, the 17th of August, Michael Lashley misled the Parliament of Barbados when he spoke both in the opening and the wrap-up of the debate by seeking to convey the impression that there was no contract in, that there was a contract in place with TICO at Constance and George. The former chairman made it absolutely clear that despite her many efforts and alerts that TICO had not executed a contract with, as the contractor, with the National Housing Corporation at Constance and St. George. Minister Lashley said in the morning that there was a finance contract and then went on to talk about it vaguely. But what caused the problem was in his wrap-up, because in the wrap-up of his speech, he delivered himself of these words, and I quote specifically. Further, it is evident that on the 30th of June 2010, I think it was about 3:52 p.m., the acting general manager reported to the board that the first tranche of $40 million was available to draw down. Now, those comments came from the minutes, which I will share with you yet again. The minutes of the 30th of June at 3:52 p.m. of the National Housing Corporation. Those comments, which Mr. Lashley referred to just now in his wrap-up, come at the bottom of page 3 of paragraph 20 of the minutes. It so happened that on the same page, not a different page than his fingerprints would have been on the same page that his fingerprints would have been on, that's quoted from, were two paragraphs that made it absolutely clear that there was no contract in place with the contractors people holding incorporated. And I refer specifically, I quote, paragraph 12, the general manager acting further indicated that to date the contract had not been executed. Beginning of paragraph 13, the board of directors expressed alarm that in spite of a contract having not been put in place by the contractor, the work was allowed to proceed. Now, you cannot want any clearer language than this. It was the National Housing Corporation that would have to execute a contract. These were minutes of the board of the National Housing Corporation. These minutes reflect the general manager of the National Housing Corporation making it clear that there was no contract in place. These minutes make it clear on the same page that Mr. Lashley quoted from, that it was the board of directors that expressed the land that in spite of a contract having not been signed by the contractor, the work was being allowed to proceed. And ironically, these minutes also make it clear that members of the board felt that the board, the corporation, should enforce a performance clause. So they were clearly concerned about a project that was delayed and for which consideration was being given about the enforcement of the performance clause. Now, those details that I have just given you are just the evidence. But the charge is misleading Parliament. You cannot have a member of Parliament, far less a minister, misleading Parliament. This is a basic precept recognized by all civilizations across the world. I quoted in England the example of John Kusumo, who in 1963 had to resign from Parliament, not because he had sexual relations with a woman who was having sexual relations with a Russian spy, but because he lied to the House of Commons. And as a matter of interest, the person who broke the story on John Kusumo was a woman by the name of Mandy Rice Davies. The similarities are too much. And if you do your research, you'll find even more similarities. In the instance of Bill Clinton, President Clinton was not carried before Congress on impeachment charges because he had sexual relations with Monica Lewinsky. He was carried there because he lied under oath. This notion of lying is also now occupying the Jamaican public. And those of you who follow the news would have seen in the last 2 days the opposition calling on the Prime Minister to resign for lying to Parliament. And equally, you would have seen the churches in Jamaica and social commentators now coming out and calling on the Prime Minister in Jamaica to resign for lying to Parliament. So that this is not an issue that is peculiar to the opposition party. This is one of the basic tenets of our parliamentary democracy. And we believe that this matter is of sufficient import that the minister, having failed to do the honourable thing, should now seek to have his instrument withdrawn by the acting Prime Minister. I will go on to this